Hey guys, I'm Trevor Fletcher. I'm in the Drama 30 class, and for my oral presentation, I chose to talk about some global issues we are facing, just some worldwide issues we go about in our daily lives. Three movies I chose to talk about: American Me, which follows Edward James Olmos. He's the guy who's playing the main character we're following, who is part of the Mexican Mafia, and we're going to be taking a look into his life. Stand and Deliver, again, another Edward James Olmos movie. He is a calculus teacher, and he's working to flip the program around at where he's working. Mi Familia, another story about a Mexican family and kind of just their story of what they've done, what they've been through in their life as being Mexican-Americans, and let's just get started. So the three issues we're going to be looking at in American Me is gang violence, becoming institutionalized, and the poor communities, which ties into the gang violence. So with that movie and gang violence, what the issue we have there is that these prisons, once you get into the prison, you're no longer part of the gang or whatever street you're from. You're just part of whatever race you are, which further separates our society even more, especially inside of a prison. And that is kind of just a concern to me because it makes me question how our prison system's actually working with the way we go about our business and letting these people group up the way they do, which also leads to becoming institutionalized. American Me goes through Olmos, the main character, he goes through this kind of situation where he's institutionalized, and when he is released from prison, he does not know much about the world out there besides being a prisoner. So he does not know how to drive a car, he never really learned how to dance, he never really properly learned how to make love to a woman. And again, that just kind of makes me question the whole prison system, if we're doing things the right way, or if we're just ruining people and not setting them up for better outcomes in their life after prison. And with these poor communities, you could see in this movie that the younger kids in these poor communities kind of look up to the older gang members, because that's really all they really see in their community, because they're not part of the upper class, which is given a lot more opportunity and a lot more chances for success compared to these guys, who really only see gangs and think that's their only outcome for them in their lives as well. Which again, it's a little bit sad to think that just because of your situation, that's really going to be your outcome. Especially in this movie, you see that happen to Olmos's, I think it's his brother, kind of ends up following in suit of what he's doing, and it turns him into a gang member instead of someone that could have possibly moved on and done something better with his life. So moving on to Stand and Deliver, we're going to be talking about poverty, faculty care and support for the student and teacher environment, and some discrimination issues. So with the poverty, the school's main issue, and Escalante's main issue, is getting good funding for the school, because kind of like in American Me, they're coming from a poor community, a poor environment, which runs them again into the issue of gangs and kind of leading them in that cycle of being in gang violence and their families following in suit, because that's all they know because of their unfortunate circumstances. Another issue that you see is the poor faculty care. You see in the movie a lot of these staff members seem to not care about the student success and do not seem to want to fund any kind of schooling that will help them better themselves in life and not have to be stuck with any kind of, again, possible gang affiliation. And that to me is a little bit sad, because these guys, I feel like a teacher is supposed to help a student learn and grow and blossom as a student, as a person. And it's just sad to see how these people simply just don't care. They choose to accept what the circumstances are and don't strive for any kind of change. Another issue we see in this is a form of discrimination. The students take the AP test, the calculus students, they take the AP test and they become accused of cheating. He plays the teacher, Mr. Escalante. He points out to these people that are running the AP test that they're kind of just doing this based off their last names and their kind of Chicano Latino backgrounds and not off the work they've done. So that becomes another unfortunate discrimination that we see, and another world problem that we go through is people judging someone just by their name or what they look like, which is definitely not fair for us and humans living together in a society. Finishing off with Mi Familia, we're going to be talking about racism, primarily with the character Chucho, finding someone to trust, and expectations being some issues. Starting with racism, the first thing we kind of see is Chucho being wrongly shot and killed. Even though he did murder a rival gang member, it's still wrong of police to be killing him just for who he is, what he's doing. So in that whole movie, his whole family is kind of upset about the racism that they feel like they were wronged with by the police and the white society. A big kind of worldwide issue is finding someone to trust in this world we're living in. It's hard to find someone to talk to and relate to. And a big character that did that for us was Jimmy. He held up a lot of walls, being that he saw Chucho shot and killed right in front of him. He held up some walls and got into some trouble, all because he had nowhere to release his feelings. And we see that a lot with people in the world we live in today, kind of bottling up those emotions and kind of using it in negative ways. And that's just a sad thing to do, but finding someone to trust is definitely an issue we go through when we walk through our lives. And the third issue I kind of see with this movie and tying into Real Women Have Curves is having expectations. I know in this movie, the parents of one of the girls of the family was expected to be a nun, and she did not want to do that. Eventually turned the life around to do something else, and her parents definitely were upset about that. And then nailing into Real Women Have Curves, the mom of that woman expected her to be a lot slender and slimmer than what she was. And I think in this world, we see a lot of parents holding our children to standards that they might not feel is fair, and it kind of puts them in this high anxiety, high depression kind of mood, and it's a sad thing to put your kid through.